Hey guys, RTT back here for the NVO guys. Today we have a launcher that's kind of interesting. So this is a Windows 11 launcher. It's actually called Computer Launcher 2. I'll have it linked down below in the description. But pretty much what this is a Windows 11 type look to the Surface Duo. So as you guys can see, we are running the Surface Duo 2. And I'll say one thing that kind of interests me is that this actually used to run perfectly fine on the Surface Duo 1. On a Surface Duo 2, this actually crashed on me a couple times now, and it's kind of still a little buggy, so I'm not sure what's going on with the Duo 2 versus the Duo 1, because the Duo 1 used to run this all the time, and it worked perfectly fine. With that being said, though, on the Duo 2, it still works very good. It's just, as you guys can see right here, all the applications on the left-hand side there are actually disappeared. They're not actually gone. They are there, just like you see in phone mode, those applications on the left-hand side here, they are still there when you go ahead and open up the actual display. And if you go ahead and click on the display, the menu actually does pop up like normal, but for some reason it does not work in tablet mode. I have no idea why. So if you have it in this mode right here, we can actually go ahead and click on this button right here and actually see all of our launcher menu options. Again, like I said, it does, for some reason, Surface Duo 2, this simply just gets bugged out when in tablet mode. I'm not sure. We have camera, lock screen, gallery, launcher widgets. We have remove page, create page. We have system widgets, wallpaper, colors, themes, refresh, desktop, settings, and all of those cool options. And of course, these are all the options right here for our launcher widgets. Now, the cool thing about this is it does give you that Windows 11 type vibe. And starting off right away, it does not have the menu bar across the middle though, which I really wish it did. And there's actually another simulator, Windows simulator, in the actual Play Store that gives you that, but everything else, it makes you charge you money. So this is like the only free app that's really honestly free, and it works very well. So if we go ahead and go in the right-hand corner here, we actually have our notification panel. And again, this would be like if this Surface Duo 2 was actually running Windows 11, this would kind of be what it looks like. Now it'd be more polished than this, it wouldn't be as glitchy and buggy, but it would still look very much like how it looks on the screen right now. So we have our airplane mode, all of our quick settings, which of course is our control panel. We have our volume, not volume marker, our brightness right there. We also do have our power, our icon right down here, which of course actually takes me right to, interesting, it takes me right to my pictures. We also have my settings. We have either ringer on or off. We also do have that right there, which is our photo icon we'll look at in a second. And if we go ahead and go to the left here, we actually do have a calendar app, which we can actually see, bam, it pops up my calendar right there, exactly what day. I can set events just like normal for any other device. And then we have our little icon right here, which gives me my Bluetooth, my battery percentage, my ringer on or off, my LTE, and of course my 5G, and then I do have my Wi-Fi right there. Currently, I do not have my SIM in this phone. Trying out something with the beta for the Fold 3. I'll have a video soon talking about that, guys. Anyway, though, if we go to the left-hand side here, we have some icons stationed at the very bottom here. We have Cortana. We have Messages, Phone, and, of course, Microsoft Edge. We go ahead and click on any of these applications just like that. Bam, it will pop up my phone app, and we can slide straight back to my home screen. Same concept with Microsoft Edge. And if you guys are a long time watcher of the channel, you guys already know I pull up this reference every single time we talk about the Duo 1 and Duo 2. Anyway, though, messaging, same concept right there. So if I pull up the left hand corner here where the start icon is, this is actually where you get all your different files, all your different actual applications. And I will say this looks very nice. Now, I will say to this day, I absolutely love In the Door Launcher 10, and I will never get away from Launcher 10. Launcher 10 will be the only launcher I ever use on this cell phone when it comes to a long time launcher. I just can't get away from it because Launcher 10 is so fluent, so amazing. I absolutely love and adore it. But with that being said, though, this one is still a really good launcher, as you guys can see, when it's not buggy and glitchy, like I said before. But you have all your applications just like that, straight right there. Now, of course, we go ahead and click on any of these applications like this PC. You guys can see it literally looks like an actual full-on desktop PC folder. And yes, so ads down there, down below, you can actually get rid of, remove ads for $1.99. So It's not really that expensive to get rid of ads completely. I would do it if this wasn't actually so buggy and glitchy for me right now. Again, that might just be me personally. This might not be buggy or glitchy for you, because there are some applications I've used on the Surface Duo 2 where some people absolutely adore them and I have issues with them. So it's vice versa. There's applications that I love that other people have issues with. With that being said, though, as you guys can see, it literally looks like an actual PC. And if you go ahead and open it up full on screen here and I go ahead and click on it again, you guys can see it does pull up what looks like an actual desktop PC. We have our My PC down there on the folder on the left hand side here, downloads, music, videos, and all that kind of good stuff. And I do love this look. Again, like I said, this is what it would be like if you had an actual desktop PC on, if you had Windows 11 on this actual phone. So like I said before, on the left hand side here, there are applications, but they're glitched out, they're bugged out. You can't see them, but they are actually there. And when you use this in tablet mode, that's when you really get that full-on Windows 11 desktop PC type of look, and I really do like that, and I think it really does complement this device. If I go ahead and pull out this one right here, you guys already know this is my keyboard slash mouse for my foldable mouse slash keyboard, my Surface Duo 2. Talked about this in a separate video, but if I go ahead and do that, you guys can see now I have my little trackpad on my little mouse here. And sorry that it's a little laggy when it comes to watching this back for you guys. But I can actually go ahead and bam, go down to the left-hand corner here, select that, pull that up, and now I literally have like my own little PC. This is actually really freaking dope. So I can go ahead and click on Office here, right? All right, let me go ahead and start doing a paper here again. All right, let me go ahead and click on that. I think I might have to click on Edit here. Actually, can I start typing? I can start typing just like that. Start typing. Let me see, I can zoom in. May not zoom in too far here. I got some specs from the Surface Duo 1 here. I got a, again, like I said, it's a little buggy, but overall, I mean, start typing, whatever, off my keyboard. I have my mouse right here. If I want to get out of this, again, like always, I'm going to try to do this my first time here, but just like that, bam, and I can click out of it, and it works perfectly fine. So, like I said, this is what Windows 11 would look like on a Surface Duo, right? A Surface Duo 2. And I will say overall, you know, it'd be more polished if Microsoft did go ahead and give us this on, you know, Surface Duo 2. But it's still a really cool concept overall. And I do definitely love looking at these launchers. Not for the reason of like, oh my God, Windows 11. It's just because it's like, what if, you know, what could have been of the Surface Duo 2 if it wasn't pushed toward Android? Because if you guys do not know, the Windows Surface Duo 1 was a Windows device. It was going to run Windows OS, and then it wasn't capable enough, it wasn't stable enough, so Microsoft pushed Android on it at the last second. Later down the line here, we have the Surface Duo 2 right here running, of course, Android 11. Eventually, Android 12L, eventually, as I'm very excited to see that ends up happening with this device. But overall, I will say, this actual full-on launcher, I gotta give it a 6 out of 10 because it is very practical, it is very usable, but the issues with this screen right here, how the apps aren't loading on the left-hand side, and also the widgets aren't loading for tablet mode. And it did crash on me like 3 times. Now, the reason why I think it crashed on me was because I had like 4 or 5 applications open. And what I learned with the Surface Duo 2 is if you are going to open up anything, do not have many applications open. Close all applications before you open up anything. You're going to crash your device if you don't. Not crash your device, you're going to crash the program app you're using. With that in mind, though, 6 out of 10 is my review for this, guys. Tell me down below your thoughts and opinions. What would you personally rate this launcher for Surface Duo 2? I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.